गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वनकम, नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब. ऑल द मेडिकल एस्पिरेंट्स हु हैव अपीयर्ड फॉर नीट 2020 एंड हैव नॉट गॉट इनटू देयर ड्रीम कॉलेजेस, डोंट वरी, वी हैव अ गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर यू गाइस. कम एंड ज्वाइन आवर रिपीटर बैच व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 5th of November 2020 एंड दिस बैच इज गोइंग टू बी अप टिल योर नीट 2021. We at Avtar are experienced faculties from all over India and we are going to provide you the best coaching, the best material, what you need to make your dream come true in the top medical institutes of India. So come and join our hands and make your dream come true. All the best. Good evening, everyone. How are you? Warm welcome to all of you. Good evening, good evening, good evening. Am I audible? Yes? Okay. So today, students, we have come for the last demo session for today. Okay. The classes will be going to start from 12th. Registration for early bird are still going on. And you have the last date of early bird registration is 15th November 2020. So all the NEET aspirants, kindly avail the offer. Early you come, early you get benefited out of it. Okay. So today topic is regarding microbes in human welfare, class 12 topic. And this is a very easy topic, scoring topic. And in the NEET 2019, 3 to 4 questions were from out of this. Okay. NEET 2020, 2 questions were there from this part. So we have to be very, learn those important topics which are more scoring also. So these kind of strategy will be helping you to score more in the NEET examination. So this is a very easy topic. So today what I'm going to talk about is, as I keep on mentioning you, that what is more important for all of you is NCERT. So I just want to let you know, for a topic, okay, maybe let it be an easy topic or a difficult topic, how you have to study NCERT. Okay, so when you are going to study NCERT, on a quick like revision you are doing, you will be able, if you are able to mark your important points and all, you don't have to go through the things again and again. You can skip on the things which you already know, okay, and you can focus on the important points, important things which you keep on forgetting. So today we'll begin with the class and then we are going to have a mentee quiz. Okay, so let us start the class on microbes in human welfare. Okay, so when you open your chapter from NCERT, so NCERT have given the syllabus, microbes in household products, which are the microbes which you require, microbes in industries, microbes in sewage, microbes in production of biogas, and microbes as biocontrol and biofertilizer. So students, if you are preparing for board examination also, here are your 6 questions, okay, 6 direct questions and all. What is the role of microbes in household products, industrial products, sewage treatment, production of biogas, in biocontrol agents and also biofertilizers? Okay, so these questions, these 6 questions will be asked, take as if you are preparing for board examination. If you are repeating and all, then you have to again go through your NCERT again and you have to learn about important points. For example, most of you will not be reading one question over here. Okay, so there are various microorganisms which can cause, which can be useful, which can be harmful. Okay, so among them, the proteinaceous infectious agents, they are prions. Okay, so this is one question which you would have missed out. Okay, so what I am trying to say is, reading line by line of NCERT is very important. Okay, let it be any image, let it be this thing. So how you cannot see the microorganism, then how you can grow the microorganism. For growing the microorganism, you need to provide them a media, and this media is called nutritive media. Okay, nutritive media. And when the microbe will grow on this, they will form on the nutritive media, the microbes is going to form colony. Okay, and looking into the number of colonies, you can calculate the number of bacteria. Okay, so this is helpful in studying of the number of enumeration of the microorganisms. Okay, and further studying the characteristics of microorganisms. Okay, then you have the picture for the virus bacteriophage. Okay, so you should know the structure of the bacteriophage. Yes, a bacteriophage. So what is a bacteriophage? A bacteriophage is nothing but a virus that attacks the bacteria. Yes, so you should know about adenovirus, which cause respiratory infection. So very important, again the question comes over here, microbes which are harmful, adenovirus. Now you say, sir, we have not studied about adenovirus. This is given in your NCERT, adenovirus which is causing the respiratory infection. Then tobacco mosaic virus, what is the shape? Rod shape. What is the shape? Rod shape is the tobacco mosaic virus. So here are the structure of tobacco mosaic virus. So then we look into the, this is the colonies of the bacteria. Okay, so as I told you, this each colony represent group of bacteria. And similarly, when we are going to grow the fungus, fungus will also form the mycelium covering on the nutrient media. Okay, so we can get a fungal colony, we can get a bacterial colony on the, this is how the cultivation. Now the important thing, the first question which comes over here is regarding microbes in human household conditions. Okay, what are the microbes in the household? So if you will look into this question, now this is the NCERT, directly based on NCERT, how you have to study it. So already you just don't have to read book by book, you have to analyze. Morning you had bread, morning you had cheese, morning you had idli dosa. All are the fermented product of microorganisms. All are the fermented product of micro. Or let it, you have a curd. So you have to just look into your household things. What kind of products you are using? Now you say, sir, cheese, how it is the cheese? Cheese we are not using at home. We are not using, but if you go to the Europe and all, people do make cheese at home. They do the fermenting of the cheese and all. So there are different kind of cheese, okay, will be there. People make some kind of homemade liquor, okay, some made alcoholic beverages, they are going to make. Fermented products are there. So we are all going to talk about how are the microbes can be used in making some kind of household products. Curd, first we are going to talk about curd. So if you look into the curd, curd is by lactic acid bacteria. Now when the curd is to be formed, how it is curd is formed? Take the milk, boil the milk, bring it lukewarm, and in the lukewarm milk add the bacteria. Which bacteria? Lactobacillus. Okay, and lactobacillus will produce lactic acid which will coagulate the milk protein. And what is going to happen? And the this produce acid, what acid? Lactic acid, which will coagulate the milk and help in converting milk into curd. Okay, then this bacteria also helps in releasing the vitamin B12 in our body. So this is also important, and vitamin, so it helps in your increasing the vitamin B12. So it helps to overcome the problem of pernicious anemia. Okay, then second thing we are going to talk about, lactic acid bacteria play a beneficial role in disease causing microorganism. This is also very important. Students, there is a word in case of probiotics. Okay, you would be coming across some kind of products like Yakult. Yakult, this is a product which is coming in the market. Okay, it is nothing but it contains some kind of probiotic organism. What is probiotic? There will be group of organisms which will not cause any kind of damage. You are going to drink these microbes, these will help in digestion. This will act, they will cover the surface of your intestine so that they do not provide the space for the harmful bacteria. So when, for example, when you are taking antibiotic, antibiotic is not only killing the useful bacteria, but it is also killing harmful bacteria. So whenever your diet is containing antibiotic, so you need to take some kind of probiotics, because then you are in more chance than some kind of infections may happen. So no infections may happen due to some kind of bacteria or some pathogen. We are taking some kind of probiotic, because probiotic bacteria like lactic acid bacteria in the curd, they help in checking the disease causing microbes. This is very important point which you would have missed out. Okay, so similarly, what are the microbes which are used for in the making of bread? We have Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Okay, so whenever we are trying to make the bread, there are holes in the bread. Why the holes in the bread? Because of liberation of carbon dioxide. So if we look into the CO2, CO2 gas is going to be there, and this is for making bread. And what is the bread called? This is the bread is being fermented by yeast, and the yeast is called baker's yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Okay, we also make a traditional drinks and all. Okay, this thing, toddy, which is a traditional drink which is made up of fermented date palm and all, coconut and all, they are made from the, this drink is made in the South India very commonly. Okay, then we are going to talk about some kind of cheese are going to be formed. So what are the different types of cheese is going to be formed? So first we will form Swiss cheese. There are large holes in the Swiss cheese. What causes the large holes in the Swiss cheese? The large holes in the Swiss cheese is mainly due to the fermentation, okay, of carbon dioxide. And who is going to form the Swiss cheese? The name is telling, Swiss. Who have gone to Switzerland? So we have Sharma ji going to Switzerland. Propionibacterium sharmani. So there is a, which organism is helpful in manufacture of Swiss cheese? So remember, Sharma have gone to Switzerland. Sharmani, okay. Propionibacterium sharmani. And there is going to be large holes. So like this, you try to have a link and try to understand, like when the words, sometimes it will be very difficult to pronounce the name. Propionibacterium sharmani. Just remember, Sharma you have heard about. Okay, Propionibacterium, it's a bacterium, Propionibacterium sharmani. Okay, which is going to make Swiss cheese. Similarly, we have Roquefort cheese, Penicillium roqueforti. Okay, so different kind of cheese are available. So this is the one. So microbes, what are the microbes? Microbes used for making curd, microbes used for making bread, microbes used for making fermented drinks like toddy, microbes used for making cheese. All these are microbes which are used for making idli and dosa. Microbes used for making idli and dosa. What is the microbes? So, leukonostoc. Leukonostoc mesenteroids. So these are the microbes which are used in the household. First question, done. Next question. Next question is microbes which are used in the industrial products. So in the industrial products, we are going to talk about two things. One is beverages, alcoholic beverages, and second is antibiotics, okay, which are used in this thing. So what are the this thing? So for large growing, for cultivating microbes at a large scale, we need a big vessel, and this big vessel is called fermenter. Okay, with this in biotechnology also you would have learned about fermenter. Yes, here also. So what is fermenter? Fermenters are nothing but large vessel which are used to grow the microbes, and microbes will act on the substrate, their food, at optimum conditions, and it will be converted into the product. So what are the microbes which are used for making alcohol? Again, the microbe which is used to make alcohol is again the yeast. Okay, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. And the Saccharomyces cerevisiae is going to make the alcohol, and this Saccharomyces cerevisiae is called now brewer's yeast. What is it called? Brewer's yeast. brewer's yeast, and different kind of alcoholic beverages are there. One could be distilled and non-distilled, which are produced by distillation. They are distilled, and which is produced by distillation, they will contain more amount of alcohol. What are the drinks which are produced by distillation? It may include brandy, it may include whiskey, gin. All these things will contain maximum amount of alcohol. So what are the drinks? So the drinks, for example, beer, brandy or rum, whiskey, brandy, rum, these are distilled. Which are the non-distilled alcoholic beverages? Wine and beer. These are non-distilled. Okay, so very important, the Saccharomyces cerevisiae can make up till 12 to 14%. After 12 to 14%, the alcohol which they are going to ferment, okay, the alcohol which is produced after fermentation, it will kill the yeast itself. That's why, because alcohol, these days we are use alcohol as a sanitizer. Alcohol is used to kill the microbe. Who is making the alcohol? Microbe. On what the alcohol is acting? Alcohol is acting also on the microbe. So even the yeast which is producing the alcohol, the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, the brewer yeast, even it dies because of alcohol. Okay, so we have talked about, so here we have alcoholic drinks. Whiskey, brandy and rum are produced by distillation, and the other two are non-distilled drinks. So with or without distillation, so we have wine and beer without distillation, and whiskey, brandy and rum with distillation. This is one thing. Next, so look into the fermenter, large thing. So this is a fermentation plant they have given in the industry. Then you have to talk about antibiotics. Now, antibiotics, when was the antibiotics discovered? Who have discovered the antibiotics? What, from where is the most of the antibiotics formed? Antibiotics, okay. Antibiotics, what are antibiotics? Antibiotics are the produced by microorganisms which are used to kill other microorganisms. Okay, they are secondary metabolites which are produced by matter. So antibiotics, very, very important, secondary metabolite which is not directly used by the microorganism. It does not play a direct function in the microorganism, but it has some other role. So those kind of substances are called secondary metabolites. So antibiotics are the chemical substances which are produced by some microbes and can kill or retard the growth of disease causing microbes. It could be bactericidal or bacteriostatic. Bactericidal will kill, bacteriostatic is going to stop the growth. So who have discovered the antibiotic? The first antibiotic discovered was penicillin. And who have discovered the penicillin? The penicillin was discovered by Alexander Fleming, Flore and Chain. So here are the names. Alexander Fleming, while working with Staphylococci, okay, they're working and obtained from Penicillium notatum. So Alexander was working on what? Staphylococci. And from where he have obtained? He have obtained penicillin from Penicillium notatum. Who have given further contribution? Earlier, later, what is going to happen? It was Ernest Chain and Flore, Howard Flore. They have later established that this antibiotic can be used to treat the patients and all. And it was used further for the treatment of the victims of the World War II. And because of this, after World War II in 1945, all the three scientists were awarded Nobel Prize. So in 1945, they were awarded Nobel Prize. Who was giving? Fleming, Chain and Flore. So this was one part. Next, we come to what are the common diseases, okay? And what is their common name, okay? So what are the diseases? So antibiotics have been improved to treat important diseases. What are those diseases? Let us talk about Kali Khansi, whooping cough. Okay, Kali Khansi, whooping cough, diphtheria, galgotu, plague due to Yersinia pestis, leprosy, kushtarog. So these are the kind, these antibiotics have been used to kill the microbes which causes plague, whooping cough, diphtheria or your galgotu and your leprosy which is Kushth Rog. So this is also very important. Okay. So now next, what are the chemicals and the enzymes and other bioactive molecule produced by the microbe? Here we are going to talk about acid. Four acid you have to remember: A, B, C, acetic acid, butyric acid, citric acid, and then you have to talk about another acid which is your lactic acid. So remember the mnemonic: A, B, C, L for acid. A, acetic acid, butyric acid, citric acid and lactic acid. Lactic acid you have already studied, lactobacillus. Yes, lactic acid bacteria. ABC remember: A, acetic acid, acetobacter acidi; B, butyric acid, clostridium butylliticum; C, citric acid, aspergillus niger. Aspergillus niger, a fungus producing citric acid, very important. Acetobacter acidi, a bacterium, acetic acid. Clostridium butylliticum, again a bacteria which is going to produce butyric acid. So these are the acids which are produced by the chemicals which are going to be produced by the bacteria or by the fungus. Next question about the microbes is, what are the microbes which are used in making some kind of enzymes? So for oil stains, if you have on your clothes some kind of oil stain, we wash with detergent, and nowadays the detergents are giving advertisement with enzyme based technology. What is that enzyme based technology? For any oil stains, oil, fat, lipids and all. So what is there? To remove the lipid, you need lipase. So Candida lipolytica is producing lipase, which are used in detergent formulation. Okay, which are used for in detergent formulation. Now also we are using ethanol. If we are making ethanol for commercial production of ethanol, we are using the Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Third, for clarification of juices, for clearing the juices, you have seen in bottle juices, if you make at home the juice and you take a Real or Tropicana juice, the Real and Tropicana juice are more clear. The clarification done is done with the help of, there is a strepto, here is the this thing. So the clarification of the bottle juice over here, the bottle juice clarification is also done by pectinases and proteases. Okay, so pectinases are used for the clarification of bottle juices, and then in the leather industry, proteases are used for softening of the leather. Okay, then there is a enzyme streptokinase, which is used to dissolve the clot. Okay, so for example, there is a internal clot formation and all. So in the blood vessel, to remove that clot, there is a clot buster. The enzyme is streptokinase, which is obtained from streptococcus. So streptokinase is there, which is obtained from the bacteria streptococcus. This enzyme, okay, is modified by genetic engineering. Not natural, it is modified by genetic engineering and is used as a clot buster. What is the clot buster? Which is used for removing clots from the blood vessels of the patient who have undergone myocardial infections leading to heart attack. Okay, so for the patients who have undergone the myocardial infections leading to heart attack, the clot buster is given. What is the clot buster? Streptokinase. Is it produced from normal streptococcus? No, the streptococcus have been modified by genetic engineering. Important part. Then we can talk about another bioactive molecule for which is acting as an immunosuppressive drug, cyclosporin A. Who is producing cyclosporin? The cyclosporin A is produced by, for the immunosuppressive drug. Whenever we are having any transplant from outside, our immune system will reject it. Yes, then we have to suppress our immune system to accept the foreign graft. Then which medicine is given? Cyclosporin A is given. Who is producing cyclosporin A? Trichoderma polysporum. Okay, then we have talked about in case of lowering the cholesterol level, there is another drug which is the doctors recommend, statins. Statin. Who is producing the statin? It is produced by yeast. Which yeast is called? Monascus purpurus. Okay, it is used to lower blood cholesterol level. Who is here? Monascus purpurus. So this you have to remember. Then, so this is our third question. Now fourth question coming. Very important question. Microbes in sewer treatment. Microbes in sewer treatment. So we'll talk only up till here because of time limitation. We won't be able to go further because we have to take mentee quiz also. So microbes in sewer treatment, very important part. I will do with this. So microbes in sewer treatment, we have three type of treatment for normal sewage: primary, secondary, tertiary. Here we are only going to talk about two treatments: primary treatment and secondary treatment. Primary treatment is a physical treatment, secondary treatment is a biological treatment, because microbes will be used only in the secondary treatment, not in the primary treatment. Primary treatment, there will be first sequential filtration followed by sedimentation. Okay, sequential filtration followed by sedimentation. So what is there? So waste water is treated. How? It is treated by sewage treatment plant, STP. Okay, so what are the two process for the STP? There is primary treatment. So look into this, STP is shown over here. So there is a primary treatment. So here how it is removed? First it is done by large and small part, or done by filtration. After filtration, what is there? Sedimentation. Then what you are going to remove? What you are going to remove? These are removed. So what has happened? These are removed in stages. Initial floating debris is removed by sequential thing. Anything which is floating on the water will be removed. After that, you are going, after whatever is settled down, the down will settle, it is called primary sludge. And whatever is left at the top is called primary effluent. The primary effluent is taken for the secondary treatment. The effluent from the primary settling tank is taken for the this thing. So primary effluent. So who, what part of the primary after water treatment, sewage treatment, in the primary treatment, first is sedimentation, okay, filtration, sequential filtration followed by sedimentation. After sedimentation, the one which is settled down is called primary sludge, and primary sludge will contain some kind of soil and small pebbles which are called grit, which is called grit, okay. And then the top part is called the effluent, primary effluent, which is taken for the secondary treatment. The secondary treatment, as it is given in highlighted, it is a biological treatment. It is a biological treatment. It is first, the primary effluent is taken into the first chamber, which is the aeration tank. Aeration tank followed by the, we are going to take into the, look into here. The first in the primary effluent is passed into the large aeration tank where it is, air is mixed, where air is bubbled out. Why air is bubbled out? To reduce BOD, to reduce BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. We have removed floating, we have removed the sediments. Now we have to remove the organic material. For removing the organic material, we have to use biological treatment process. That's why we are studying in microbes in human welfare, how the microbes can be used for the secondary treatment. So in case of the sewage, there will be some kind of oxygen which is dissolved in the water. That oxygen is called DO. Who is taking the oxygen? Microbes will be taking the oxygen. Microbes will be taking the oxygen and it will degrade the organic matter. So remember that organic matter which is there in the sewage, organic matter which is there in the sewage, it will be degraded. Organic matter will be degraded. Who will degrade the organic matter? There will be microbes. But these microbes require what? Oxygen. So if the microbes are going to take the oxygen from the water, then the dissolved oxygen will decrease. Okay? So if there is more organic matter, there is less dissolved oxygen and more is biochemical oxygen demand. So remember one thing, DO is inversely related to BOD. DO is inversely related to BOD. Very, very important in your ecology also, environmental issues also, you have the what is the relation between BOD and DO. So it is inversely related. More is the biochemical oxygen demand, lesser is the DO. Okay, so now what will happen? The aerobic microbes, let it be bacteria and fungus, they will get aggregate and form flocks. Very important. Masses of bacteria associated fungus, they are going to form flocks. And what they are going to do? They are going to reduce the BOD. They are going to reduce the BOD. If they are going to reduce the BOD, they are decreasing organic matter. So organic matter is being removed. Okay. Now what will you do with this bacteria and fungus? You will take them into the next chamber, which is a settling tank, and this bacteria and fungus will settle down, and this is called activated sludge, which will settle down. Very important. Now you are going to take the into the settling tank where the bacteria and the fungus will settle down, the flocks are going to settle down, and this is called activated sludge. Most of the activated sludge you will take into anaerobic sludge digester, where in the anaerobic condition you are going to kill them. However, some part of the activated sludge is put back into the aeration chamber, which act as an inoculum for formation of the flocks and reducing the BOD at a higher, faster rate. Okay, so this is also important. So finally, during the digestion, what is going to happen? In the anaerobic sludge digester, there are going to be mixture of gases. What are the mixture of gases? Methane, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide. These gases are going to produce. Since it contains majorly methane, methane is a biogas, which is a source of, it can be used for cooking, lighting and heating. Okay, methane can be used for cooking, lighting and heating. Now another very important part in this is mentioned is there. In India, we have Ministry of Environment and Forestry, MOEF, okay, which have initiated some plan. MOEF, Ministry of Environment, MOEF, have initiated one plan, Ganga Action Plan and Yamuna Action Plan. This is nothing in order to treat the water which is coming into the Ganga and the Yamuna. They have set up the sewage treatment plant. So every water need that is going to be drained into the Ganga or Yamuna need to be done at least two treatment, primary and secondary treatment, in order to prevent the water pollution. Okay, so we'll do only up till here. As I told you, now only few things are left. Now I will ask you questions from the mentee quiz from the same chapter. Okay, because of time limitations, we are just a demo in order to tell you how you have to read your NCRT. So I covered 4 or 5 pages of NCRT in a very fast way. Okay, so that is how you have to try to cover your chapter. Okay, but you have to read first line by line, then whatever the teacher is marking, whatever your teachers are telling you to mark and all, mark it. Any extra point is there, right over there. Don't look into the separate book for extra information and all. First listen in the class, note down the important point. Most of the question you will get from the NCRT. 99% questions are from NCRT. Okay, we go into the mentee quiz now. We have very little time. Okay, but anyhow, we'll try to have a mentee quiz. Okay, students, Your code is Your code is 9436778. 9436778. So kindly join at this code. Join fast. Those who are new to the Mentimeter, you have to go to the Play Store, download the app Mentimeter, and then you have to give this code 9436778. I'll give you 2 minutes. We'll start the quiz. Let it be any number of students. We'll start the quiz. Let's analyze. Okay, 1 minute more. We don't have time. We are running late. Come on, come on, come on. All of you, those who are new, kindly write the number 9436778. Okay, we'll start. First question on your screen. Microbes used for biocontrol of pest butterfly caterpillar is which of the following? Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Bacillus thuringiensis, IPM, all of these. Which is used for biocontrol for the pest butterfly caterpillar? Okay. IPM is Integrated Pest Management Program, okay, which can be used as a biocontrol. However, it is not a microbe. Microbe used as biocontrol. Bacillus thuringiensis, it is used for controlling of the caterpillar. Yes, cryogenes, we have already talked about this in biotechnology. Next question, so let's see who have answered it correctly. Okay. So, 3 students have answered it correctly. Lokesh, Niveta, Danush. Next question. Question number 2 on your screen. During the formation of bread, it becomes porous due to the release of CO2. By release of what? Who is going to produce the carbon dioxide when in the bread there are holes? So why it is there? It is mainly due to yeast. Very good. Yeast is there, which is going to this thing. So all have answered it correctly. We can go to the next question. All these questions are need based, which have been taken from the which gases are produced in anaerobic sludge digester? The last, what are the gases which are produced? Methane and carbon dioxide, methane, hydrogen sulfide and carbon dioxide, methane, hydrogen sulfide and oxygen, hydrogen sulfide and carbon dioxide. Easy question, but you need to have, we have same from NCERT, you have just now we have seen. Good, methane, hydrogen sulfide and carbon dioxide, all correct. Let's see who is answering very fast. Okay, so it was answered very fast by Sanjay. Okay, next question. A nitrogen fixing microbe associated with Azolla in the rice field is what? Which is in the rice field there is a relationship, okay, which help in nitrogen fixing, okay. Which is that? Spirulina, Anabina, Frankia, Tolipteryx. anabina, azola anabina relationship, very important, remember this thing. Azola anabina relationship is there in the paddy fields and help in the fixing of nitrogen. Okay. Okay, so two students have answered it correctly. Okay, next. Next question on your screen. Which of the following can be used as a biocontrol agent in the treatment of plant diseases? Biocontrol agent in the treatment of plant diseases. If you look into the biocontrol, you will get the answer. Lactobacillus, Trichoderma, Chlorella, Anabina. Which can be used for treatment of plant disease. So in the line in NCERT is there. Root-borne pathogens in the plant can be treated by dash. Only one person has given it correct answer. Trichoderma. Trichoderma is used to overcome the root-borne pathogen. Let's see who have given the correct answer. Okay. Sanjay Shri Krishna. Good. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is not a biofertilizer? Which of the following is not a bio? Agrobacterium, rhizobium, nostoc, mycorrhiza. Biofertilizer, one which can fix nitrogen, phosphorus. So which are the organisms which are not fixing nitrogen and phosphorus? Let me see. Oh, no one has given the correct answer. Agrobacterium. Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Is it fixing nitrogen? Is it fixing phosphorus? No. All are given. Which of the following is not nostoc, cyanobacteria? It is fixing this thing. Rhizobium, yes. Obviously, root nodule formation you have already seen. All are given wrong answer. This is the last part which we have not discussed today, biocontrol and biofertilizer. Next question. Which of the following pairs is wrongly matched? Yeast with ethanol, streptomycetes, antibiotic, coliform vinegar, methanogen, gobar gas. Which is wrong? Which is wrongly matched? Yes, first. Only four people have answered. Which is wrongly matched? Good. Coliform. 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 Coliform bacteria are present in our intestine, E. coli. Okay. They are not going to make vinegar. In fact, some of the bacteria like lactobacillus, they make vitamin B12. And who is going to make vinegar? Acetic acid, acetobacter, ST. Let's see who have answered it correctly. Okay. The top three have answered correctly. Next question on your screen. The guts of cow and buffalo possesses what? The guts of cow and buffalo, ruminants, methanogens, cyanobacteria, fucus, chlorella. What do they possess? What do they have? Yes, the guts of. Oh, still confusion. Methanogen. Methanogen, methane gas. We are taking gobar gas. Yes. So, methanogens. Let's see who have answered it correctly. Okay. Only the first two. Good. Sanjay Shri Krishna, Dhanush. Good. Okay. Next question. Question number 9. Monascus purpureus is a yeast used commercially in the production of what? Monascus Purpurus. Mona, I told you. Who is teaching you? Something. Ethanol, streptokinase for removing clot, for the thing, citric acid, blood cholesterol, lowering statin. Oh, again mistake. Statin. Stat teacher, Mona, Monascus Purpurus. Remember the mnemonic. Okay. Okay, only three people answer correctly. Okay, next question. Question number 10. An organism used as a biofertilizer for raising soya bean crop. Soya bean crop, biofertilizer, which organism is used? Azotobacter, Azospirillium, Rhizobium or Nostoc? This question, if you have analyzed in Mineral Nutrition 11th chapter, you can get. Rhizobium is the correct answer. Let's see who has given correct answer. Okay. Two have given correct answer. Next question. Question number 11. During anaerobic digestion of organic waste, such as in producing biogas, which of the following is left undegraded? Some part is left undegraded, some will be digested. Lipids, lignin, hemicellulose or cellulose? See, we are talking about digestion by microbes. Some part is going to be undigested. Lignin is the correct answer. Lignin will ref this thing. Let's see who have given the correct answer. Okay. They don't have enzymes to digest. Cellulose can be digested in the ruminants. Yes. Next question. When a natural predator, living being, is applied on other pathogen to control them, this process is called what? A living being controlling the population of another. What is this kind of called? Artificial control, confusion technique, biological control or genetic engineering? Biological control, when the living organisms are used to control the population of other living organisms. Yes. Okay. Next question on your screen. Question number 13. Try analyzing it nicely, students. Doing a lot of mistake. Which of the following in sewage treatment plant removes suspended solid? So where is suspended solid removed? We have talked about in the case of sewage treatment. Primary, secondary treatment, primary, what is done? Primary, what is there in the primary? Sequential filtration followed by sedimentation, which is going to remove the suspended solids. Yes. So only one wrong answer. Okay, Niveta have not understood. Okay, next question, question number 14. A patient brought to a hospital with myocardial infection, normally immediately given what? Have a clot. So you are going to clot buster. What is a clot buster? Penicillin, streptokinase, cyclosporine or statin? Yes. It's also called clot buster. Clot buster. Next question on your screen. Okay. So, Lokesh now is doing well. Okay. Next question on your screen. Question number 15. Only three questions are left, students. do nicely. Cochineal insect has proved very useful for, if you are plus two students, you can answer this. Cochineal insects have been for cactus prevention, Isharnia prevention, weed control, Parthenium control. Cochineal insects are used as biocontrol, okay, and they were used in case of American deserts for removing the cactus, okay. So cactus was introduced in North American desert, and to remove that they have introduced a cochlear insect. Okay, next question, second last question of today's session. Organism called methanogens are most abundant where? Methanogen, where will be they present? Sulfur rock, cattle yard, polluted stream, hot springs. Where will be the methanogen present? Easy question, apply the concept, you will get it. Methanogens, where are they present? Methanogens are present in ruminating organism. So answer should be cattle yard. Okay, all have done correct except Sanjay. Next question, last question, deciding one. On your screen, last question. Secondary sediment treatment is mainly a secondary treatment is mechanical process, physical process, chemical, or is it a biological process? Easy question, very easy question. Now only discuss. Secondary treatment is what process? It is a biological. Still one person is doing mistake. Okay, let's see your score. Okay, these are today's score. So Dhanush has done well, have understood and all. Good Dhanush, you have understand well and all. Okay, we can understand. Many of you have not covered the entire chapter and all. Those who have attended the classes, they have got into it. Okay, so we have just now completed our demo part. For the students who have registered or going to register, the classes will be started now on 12th. Within 2 days, the registration will be open and you have to come register, and the early bird registration will be for first 10 candidates or for up till 15th November 2020. So try to get the benefit out of it and make sure you achieve your best. Okay, so try to work hard, focus only on NCRT, make yourself firm that yes, I have to crack NEET 2021. If you are in NEET, if you are in plus one, then you have to NEET 2022. Surely I have to do it. Make your dream your target and you will achieve your. Okay, students. Thank you, everyone.